What's everybody talking about? Lance Armstrong. To be honest, I have a hard time even caring about this situation with this athlete who's now been found guilty and has confessed to having used doping and steroids and all kinds of cheating methods in order to win the Tour de France and all kinds of other biking awards for years and years and years and years. Who cares? But everybody's talking about it. And I suppose there are some interesting lessons that can be gleaned from this situation that everybody's talking about, especially the news. What we know, of course, about this man, Lance Armstrong, once regarded as a hero, now known to be a liar, a cheater, and a bully, it turns out. First thing that comes to my mind is, isn't this what always seems to happen when we put very human people on very godlike pedestals? I mean, why did we believe for so long that this guy who had cancer could then come back and win the Tour de France without the need of steroids? Why in the world didn't this occur to anybody beforehand that maybe he was cheating? It's because we want to believe it. We want to believe that a person can come back from unspeakable odds, come back from something like cancer, and still be a champion. We want to believe that those kinds of stories are true for us mere mortals. And that's when we put people on pedestals. We make them idols. We make them out to be more than they could possibly be, putting them up on pedestals from which they will inevitably fall. The second reflection is obvious. What happens when we cheat? When we lie? When we bully? Lance Armstrong thought that he was going to go on forever, for the rest of his life, being regarded as the hero. A title that he stole, by the way. But it didn't work out that way, did it? Why is that? What force is at work in the universe, making sure that the liars and the cheaters don't get away with it? That they always seem to fall in the end, just like Goliath, taken down by David. Number three, why did he cheat? Why did he lie? Why did he bully? Why did he turn into such a monumental jerk, as many of the people that worked with him have now testified? Why? And this is something that no one has really considered. I don't think even Lance Armstrong is ready to admit himself, is how much fear played a role in his whole decision-making process. Fear of not being the best. Fear of getting caught. Fear that this entire artificial world that he would have created around him would come tumbling down. A lot of us are wondering, why didn't he come clean sooner? Reality is, the more he would have lied, the harder it would have been to come clean. The harder it would have been to face the music. Oh, he'd lie even more. And be even more of a total jerk. All because he's afraid. To the point that he was probably trapped in this fear. And that's why it took him so long. That's why he was forced to come clean, not by his own choice, but by the admissions of others. And that brings me to question number four. Was he really sorry? Or is he sorry because he got caught? Believe it or not, I think, as a priest, that getting caught was probably the best thing that could possibly have happened to him, for the sake of his soul, for the sake of his true self. But it might take a while for that to sink in for him himself. So, that's the story of Lance Armstrong. Hopefully we'll have something more interesting to talk about in the news next week. For now, we can learn these lessons, and discuss them, and learn from them. Learn from Lance Armstrong. Learn that cheaters really don't prosper. Learn that we're all eventually going to face the truth, face the music, eventually.